Hey guys, welcome to my channel. It's your girl, May, and I'm back with another video. In today's video, I'm going to be telling you all about why I decided to go celibate. So many people ask me why I decided to be celibate, and I'm gonna just let y'all know because I get this question a lot, and I just wanna like tell you all how God called me to being celibate. Before we get started in today's video, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more content. I've been a Christian for as long as I can remember. I was a girl that was like, yeah, I'm gonna wait until I get married to have sex. Before I actually went celibate, I was thinking about it almost a year before actually doing it. When the thought first came to my mind, I was just like I was like behooved, like I did not think that I can do it. I was just talking to God and I was just kind of like, I don't know, maybe this is not for me. Like, I just couldn't picture myself actually being celibate. I had a hard time accepting that that was his faith for me. And like, what if I gotta wait like 10 years, 20 years? Like, those were the thoughts that was like going through my head at the time. I tried to basically make up an excuse to say that having sex before marriage wasn't a sin. And let me just clear this up for anybody who's watching. No, I'm not celibate because I think having sex before marriage is a sin. That is not the reason why I'm celibate. But if you believe in a Bible, that is in the Bible, but that's not the reason why I'm celibate. But when I first started thinking about going celibate, or when celibacy first crossed my mind, I was kind of making up excuses like, well, I like to party, I like to drink, like basically, are these things really sins? Like, do God really judge us for doing things that is quote unquote fun, I guess? Having sex with me, like, I'm the type of person where I catch feelings before having sex. In order for me to have sex with somebody, I have to have feelings for that person. So I wasn't like just out there having sex with people. My body count really isn't that much. But when I did have sex with a person, I just kind of felt like, I don't know, I always felt like used. I hate the feeling of feeling used. So after I continued to date these guys, I was just like, okay, well, first, instead of going celibate, I just want somebody who can be consistent with me. So I feel like I tried that, and that really didn't work out. After a couple of months, celibacy came back to my mind. And I was like, okay, I don't want to go celibate. God, nope, I'm not going celibate. Not for me. I'm going to just wait until I'm in a relationship. And that's when I'm going to go, like, that's when I can, you know, have sex. Because now I know the person is for me. I won't feel used. When I tell y'all, that did not work out. So I was talking to this guy, which is the last person that I had sexual intercourse with. These motorcycles really, really trying me. So basically, we was talking for a couple of weeks, actually like a month or so. And we didn't even get in a relationship and we had sex. But after him, I was just like, man, forget adding bodies. Like, I'm done with adding bodies to my body count. And y'all girls know what I mean. We want a small body count. We don't need our body count to be all up there. I was like, the next body that I add to my body count, I'm going to marry. Period. Remind y'all, through all these phases of like these rational decisions that I'm making, I made those decisions because celibacy came to my mind. I was making excuses to why I shouldn't be celibate. So the last excuse that I made was, I'm gonna just have sex with people that I already had sex with. Y'all, I thought. One day, me and my ex was texting. And remind y'all, it was like at 12 o'clock a.m. We was texting and, okay, wait. Throughout the 4 months that I wasn't having sex, I wasn't quote-unquote celibate. I was just abstinent. But throughout those 4 months, celibacy kept crossing my mind. I felt God telling me that I should be celibate, and he's calling me to be celibate. I prayed about it, and it's just like it kept coming in my mind. And like I said before, I was scared of the idea, so I never really was like, actually trying to do it. But within those 4 months, I was starting to be like, okay, you got this. You can do it. Just pray about it. You got it. You can go celibate. You can be celibate. You can wait into marriage. And I was just kind of like, basically be okay with the fact that I might not get married, or it might take me longer to get married. Like, I might be celibate for like 10 years. So I was trying to like basically be okay with that and like trying to see, was this something that I really, really wanted to do? So one night, me and my ex was texting. We was chit-chatting it up. Chit-chat-chat-chat-chatting it up. He is someone that I like had sexual contact with. So he was texting, and like I said, it was like at 12 o'clock in the morning, and he was just like, you know, come through. We haven't hung out in a long time. You should come through. This is the words that literally came out of my mouth. I said, and I'm very ashamed of this, and I already prayed about it and said my sorries to God. I can't believe I'm saying this on camera. I was like, F God, I am going to get some. That's what I said in my head. I said those words. And like, I don't know, it was the devil talking, because that couldn't have been me, a child of God. Like, that couldn't have been me. Like, I don't know what that was. But I proceeded to grab 2 condoms, put it in my purse, and I was out the door. The place that he was living was 5 to 7 minutes away from my house. I'm driving. By this time, it's like 1 o'clock in the morning. Out of nowhere, it was literally out of nowhere, a car hit me from the side. I had the right of way, and it was a stop sign right here. The car came and hit me from the side, and my whole car flipped. Like, it didn't really flip, but it like turned like a whole, it was vertical, it turned horizontal, okay? My whole car flipped over. The wheel was bent, the car had to get totaled. Thankful to God, I was okay. I didn't get hurt in the accident, nor did the other person. But y'all, like, right in that moment, I was like, I have to go celibate. God is calling me to become celibate. That was him telling me, like, I am calling you to be celibate. Your husband is going to come, and you just need to be celibate. I had no choice but to become celibate after that, because, like, I feel like that was a warning from God. He was trying to tell me something. It was meant for me to be celibate. God knows my heart. He knows that I want a husband. Everyone that I know that I want a husband. And, yeah, and I feel like this is the way that God chose to bring me my husband. During that time, that was a very scary moment for me, the accident situation. And I am so thankful that I didn't get hurt, or the other person. The car got towed, and I didn't see the ex that night. I just went home. I got a ticket that night because my headlights wasn't on. The police just took me home, because at that point, my mind was made up. I was going celibate. I said all this to say, if you are deciding to go celibate, if God is putting it on your heart, I encourage everyone to go celibate, especially if it is a calling from God. You definitely should do it. If it is not a calling from God, I still encourage it. Like, going celibate is just a way to focus on yourself and like to figure out who you really are, and to basically get all the distractions of like males and sex and females, if you're a male watching this. Like, it's a way to, like, just clear your mind from all that chaos and all that relationship drama. It's a lot of benefits to going celibate. If you guys want a separate video of all the blessings that I have gained in this last year and 4 months of being celibate, I will be gladly to do that video for you all. Sometimes it do get hard and I just want to stop, but I just pray about it and continue to ask God to remind me of my purpose and what he was calling me to do from the beginning, so that I can continue with my celibacy journey. And for the most part, it has been wonderful. Some days I'll be doubtful, like, what if I never find a husband? Like, is this just a waste of my time? During those times, I really like just pray about it and go to God about it, because I know it gets hard. So if you're someone out there who's deciding to be celibate, who is celibate, like, I got you. You can always DM me, inbox me. We can talk about it. But yes, like, some days it do get hard. And if you need somebody to talk to, I am here to listen and to chit chat and to talk, and we can keep each other strong on our journey. My lash is coming off throughout the video. I am very sorry for that. So that was pretty much all for my celibacy story. If you guys like this video, please give it a big thumbs up and leave me a comment down below. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click that notification bell so you can be notified when I upload videos. And yeah, guys, that was pretty much all. I'll catch you in my next one. Peace.